This is actually a dream come true because it's always been a dream to work in sports since I was a young kid. I remember watching Knicks, Rangers, Giants, and Yankee games ever since I was 5 years old. And to be able to work in sports right now, it's really a career goal of mine, and it came true. Like, my mom and my dad would watch the games when I was younger, and I was watching along with them, and they were rooting for my teams, and that's how, like, I started getting the habit of rooting for them, because my mom and dad wanted to see them win, so that's how I wanted to see them win too. 808 drums, you don't want none, better run when beef is on. In the NBA, I like the Knicks. The NHL, I like the Rangers. The NFL, I like the Giants. And in Major League Baseball, I love the Yankees. Basically, I'm in charge of athletic communications. I handle public relations, marketing, and the journalism side of our 15 athletic teams at Yeshiva University. And so I basically write the game stories. I input statistics during the games. I nominate our student athletes for awards. And basically, I make the athletic department, the athletic teams look good. This is something I wanted to pursue since I was in college, because I always wanted to be a sports journalist, but I realized that sports reporters for newspapers, they're kind of a dying breed, because newspapers, people are more interested in the internet right now rather than paper copies of the newspaper. So I figured maybe if I could work something that's more with the times, I could that could help me out. And then I started learning about the sports information side at Utica College, seeing the sports information director, Gilbert Master, and seeing what he did. And I actually interned for him my senior year, and I go, this is a great career. This is definitely something I want to pursue, because he was involved with all the teams. There was a journalistic side to it. There was a journalism side to it. There was a public relations side to it. And it's all like, I think Utica had like 24 teams at the time, and I think they still do. And so it's basically 24 teams under one roof, and I go, this is very exciting. This is something I should pursue. And it's been a few years, but I finally became a sports information director last December. It was kind of tough at first, because back when I was in college and graduate school, I figured that it's best if I work in different areas to broaden my skills. Like, for example, working in the administrative side of the athletic department, and work in different areas. But I realized that it's better to focus on one thing and concentrate on that to develop your skills even more. So even though I interned at Utica College, and I helped out a little bit at Manhattanville College when I went to graduate school there, I didn't get like the full experience of it, because I was too busy trying to like broaden my skills instead of focusing on the sports information aspect of it. So it was hard to get jobs at first, but luckily after I got my master's degree from Manhattanville, Chris Gonzalez from Lehman College, who was their sports information director, was able to take a chance on me and become his assistant in the sports information department, even though I've had very minimal experience since I didn't stay too long for my internship. And while I was at Lehman, I learned the skills necessary. I learned how to input stats. I learned how to basically do the stories the proper way, proper form of writing, and all the different little pieces in the sports information department. Thanks to mastering my skills, I was able to get the job at Yeshiva University as the head sports information director. Oh yes, I was diagnosed with autism when I was 2 years old. And then it's funny, because I remember going to special education classes and not being able to talk until I was, not say my first word until I was 3 years old, and not being able to speak full sentences until I was five. And I remember those areas pretty well. And it's actually funny, because I always thought I grew out of autism, but years later I learned that it's not possible to grow out of autism. Once you have autism, you'll always have it. And so I made that discovery about my freshman year in college. And then I was officially diagnosed with Asperger's syndrome my sophomore year when I was 20 years old. Yeah, it was hard to adjust at first, but then I just calmed myself down and said that I'm still the same person. It doesn't matter what my label is. I'm still the same person I've always been when I was younger, older. So just because like I found out something about myself, that doesn't change like who I was in the past or who I will be in the future. Well, for people with autism, there's different levels. Like, there's people that have Asperger's like me who have like the minor symptoms of autism. Then there's individuals who could still speak, but their symptoms are more severe. And there's also individuals with autism that have not been able to talk and probably will never be able to talk. And that's the tough part, because there's all different levels of autism. It's not just like it goes from here to here. Like, it's the range of the spectrum is very wide. And it's basically, the basic definition of autism is a person who has struggles with social and communication skills. And so the individuals with minor forms of autism, like Asperger's, they could still go to college, they could still go to achieve a career, but they'll still experience the symptoms of autism. And individuals with severe autism that are nonverbal, even though they can't verbally speak, they could still communicate by hand gestures and facial expressions. And it's kind of tough for the individuals who can't speak, because they want to speak, they want to communicate, and they want their voices heard, but they're not able to. And that's why they throw like a lot of tantrums, because they're just frustrated. They want to speak. They want people to hear them. Basically, don't judge. Like, if there's something going on, like if somebody's throwing a tantrum, there's got to be a reason behind that. Don't assume like it's because the child's a brat or anything. Just like, basically, just understand what from another person's shoes. Even if it, like, the kid does not have autism, still don't judge, because you never know what it's like until you're in somebody else's shoes. I always wanted to be treated the same as everyone else. I wouldn't say that autism has helped me or hurt me throughout my career. I know that's easy for me to say, but I know every individual is different. But it hasn't really helped or hindered me, because I'm just focusing on my job just like any other person would, and just focusing on my goals and getting it done. No two people with autism are ever the same. Like, even individuals that are nonverbal could still have successful careers. They could still communicate with other people. They could still have good jobs. They could still help out, and it's really some incredible stuff. Like, I know people that are very good artists. They could draw really well, despite having like the most severe form of autism. So it doesn't limit your talents as someone that has autism, no matter what the level is. Oh yes, I've earned the Young Leadership Award from the Utica College Alumni Council at my alma mater back in September 25th. And it was really awesome being back to my home at the college, where everything started in terms of my career, athletic career, and seeing all my friends again. It was incredible, but it was really a huge honor to receive that award. I'm just excited to keep going my career. Like, for example, our full teams are in the home stretch right now, and playoffs are coming soon, and our team's looking to qualify for the playoffs. We also have basketball season coming up, and those are always good events here at Yeshiva, and I'm really looking forward to that.